Thanks, Natalia. And hi, everyone. My name is Jason Freeberg. I'm a product manager on Azure App Service. So in the previous two videos, Natalia showed you how to deploy a Node.js application to Azure App Service and then how to connect it to a database and storage. Now that you've done that, let's get this application ready for production use. And specifically, let's set up autoscaling so that your application will scale out horizontally when it receives more requests. Before we get started, make sure you go back to Natalia's first two videos and follow along. Once you've done that, let's open the Azure portal to your Azure web app. Once you have that open, scroll down to scale up, and you need to make sure that you're on an app service plan tier that has auto scaling. So you can see here, I've selected P1 V2, and if I scale down under included features, there's auto scale for up to 20 instances. Now, once you've made sure that you're on an app service plan that has auto scaling, click down to scale out, and you'll see that there's two options for scaling your app service plan. The first is manual scale, and by default, this should be at one instance. And you can use this slider to select a number of instances that you want, say 10 instances, and then Azure will keep your app service plan at a static 10 instances. Now, on the other hand, you can come over to custom auto scale, and then you can scale based on a metric. So here we'll click add a rule, and then we're going to scale based on our app service, and we're going to select our web app here. So this is the same application that we have right over here, NV Contoso HR app. Next thing we're going to do is select the metric that we want to scale based off. You can see in this list, there's a lot of different metrics that you can use, but for this example, we're going to use request count. Now, if we come down here, you can see that this graph is showing in blue the number of requests that we've gotten over time, and you can see there haven't been a whole lot. And then this dashed line is showing the threshold of requests that we need to get past for the app service plan to scale out. So if we keep scrolling, you can see that this is set at 70, the dashed line. And then under duration, I'm going to set this to 5 minutes. So far our scale rule is saying that when my request count is greater than 70 requests for a 5 minute period, then I want to increase my instance count by one instance. So now we'll hit add. And then last thing you need to do is make sure that you set a maximum above one instance. Otherwise, the rule will never execute. So for example, I'll set my maximum to 4 instances. Last thing to do is hit save. And now we've set up autoscaling. So now to test this, let's go back to VS Code. And then you can see here, I have a shell command ready to go. This is using the Apache benchmark tool. And if you're not familiar with it, it's pretty simple. It's just going to send 15,000 requests with a concurrent request count of 100. So at any one time, there shouldn't be more than 100 concurrent requests to the web app. That's going to take a lot of time, but you remember that we set the scale rule to only execute when there's been a consistent, or excuse me, an average of 70 requests over a 5 minute period. So we'll run this command, and then we'll come back in a few minutes when all these requests have hit our web app. All right, so we're back after a short break. All of the requests have completed. You can see the Apache benchmark tool is done here. So if we come back to the portal, you can see here already our instance count is at 2. And if we come into run history, this is showing the run history for autoscale over the past hour. And you can see here it was at one instance. And then the Apache benchmark tool kicked in, and now we're up to our 2 instances. One last thing I want to call out in our autoscale rule is you want to make sure to set a rule to scale back in. So you can say under here, decrease instance count by 1, say when your request count is less than a certain threshold, say under 20 requests, then you want to decrease your instance count by 1, just as an example. So I hope you enjoyed the video. Join me for the next video where we'll set up App Service deployment slots and a new staging environment for our web app. Thanks for watching.